Once you've done the QC as preparation, get an overview with PCA. Set the QC3 list and all measurement data set, and run. The PCA result is stored in the profile section. You can visualize it in the scatter plot samples view. The two dots near the origin represent CC control, and dots of CERNA treated samples are at the bottom left of the origin. Back to the PCA tool panel, you can open details for each principal component PC. In the detail panel, you can extract the contributing genes to the selected PC. When you switch the dataset from all samples to average, the plot also switches from individual samples to group averages. Next, let's open the tree clustering tool and run the clustering. You can run with both all samples and average. According to the PCA result, it would be appropriate to run with average. The result of clustering is stored in the tree section. You can click on a node in the tree structure to select genes under the node. The up-regulated red gene looks roughly common by CERNA treatments, whereas the down-regulated blue gene seems to be specific to each CERNA. Going back to the PCA results, the first principal component PC1 is featured by CE2, and the second principal component PC2 is by CE1. Back to the heat map, there are more genes brightly colored in CE2 and E1. However, there indeed is a cluster featured by CE3. Go back to the PCA results and drag PC3 to the horizontal axis from the results stored in the profile section. You can see that the CE3 features PC3. Consequently, PC1, PC2, and PC3 are characterized by CE2, CE1, and CE3, respectively. By comparing PCA and clustering results, you can get a better understanding of the data. Click on a node and save a measurement list of the cluster. You can do it from any tree nodes. Check out the expression patterns of each cluster with the line graph view.